.com/.news for nerds, stuff that matters. Half of US nuclear missile were implicated in cheating. Posted by Samson Piss on Thursday, January 30, 2014. From the What Did You Get for Question 4? Department. And Solar writes. Just over half of the 183 nuclear missile launch officers at Malmstrom Air Force Base in Montana have been implicated in a widening exam cheating scandal, the Air Force said on Thursday, acknowledging it had a systemic problem within its ranks. The cheating was discovered during an investigation into illegal drug possession among airmen, when test answers were found in a text message on one missile launch officer's cell phone. The Air Force initially said 34 officers either knew about the cheating or cheated themselves. But Air Force Secretary Deborah Lee James told a Pentagon news conference on Thursday that the total number of implicated officers had grown to 92, all of them at Malmstrom, one of three nuclear missile wings overseeing America's 450 intercontinental missiles, or ICBMs. Some comments on this. Score 4, interesting. What are the questions for this exam? Why do they need to cheat? Score 4, insightful. Policies and procedures stuff, primarily. They cheat because, while there is a passing score, your raw score also gets noted in member reviews. And when the review board sees that there's only 10 slots for the next rank in your specialty, and there's 20 people who graduated in the same class and all have good board interviews, of course they'll look at all your test scores next. Score 5, insightful? You don't seem to get it. That's exactly what's happening. The military is cutting troops, not re-enlisting them. When your entire career has been spent sitting in a bunker waiting for the order to destroy the world, getting laid off is a bit more of a threat to you than others. I know quite a few career military guys and they all fear for their jobs right now. Not that it's a bad thing, our military is way, way too big. But you can understand why these people are going to such lengths. Score 4, informative. You are confusing two separate issues. Perhaps intentionally. First, the military underscore may underscore be overstaffed and maybe not. Sure, we could close some remote bases or seek funding from the countries we are there to supposedly protect instead of paying them to be there. But let's not forget that a whole lot of traditional military work has gone to contractors who have almost zero accountability. I'd rather have soldiers sworn to protect the Constitution doing that work. Sure, there are always problems and Abu Ghraib was horrible. That said, at least some people were punished for it. Unlike Blackwater that has done things at least this bad yet no one gets punished. So perhaps the military is not so much overstaffed as they are used improperly and mismanaged. The second issue is how promotions work in the military. If you spent 10 years of your life serving and want to continue to retirement, you have to make rank. In order to make rank, you have go get points. Those points are nothing simple. And nothing like it exists in the civilian sector that I know of. If your job is at 35 R, there may be 100 E4 rank jobs, but only 5 jobs at E5 rank, and 1 at E6. If you have spent 12 years serving and can't get E6 in that time, you can't re-enlist. Your 12-year investment into a career is gone. And it's not like you get some great civilian job out of 12 years military service. A military mechanic, electrician, etc. is not considered the same as a civilian and very few of the military certifications count as civilian certifications. All 100 of the E4s know that they need points to get rank and if they plan to make the military a career they all do the same things. They all go to airborne school, air assault school, work to shoot well and do well on their PT tests. It's little things like these BS tests and ass kissing that get the next rank and let a person continue at their desired career. Seems like you know jack about the military on the surface, so I'll point out another huge difference between civilian jobs and military. In the civilian world you can change jobs whenever the hell you want. In the military you can't do this, you have to serve out your term. This means reserve time after active duty whether you want it or not, in addition to your active time. People that volunteer for a second term have given up a hell of a lot to protect you and your way of life. An attitude like yours ensures that we get shit people in the military, not people who care to do a good job. Considering the true purpose of their job, you don't want shitty people, there even though you may try and claim otherwise. FYI, I am a vet and lived the life. I worked in DoD for 10 years and another 20 in the civilian sector. I can speak to both sides from an educated perspective. Score 4. Funny. Example. 1. When should you launch a missile? A. Whenever you feel like it. B. Now. C. Never. D. When your commanding officer tells you to launch. E. None of the above. 2. Who can authorize a strategic launch? A. Anyone. B. The mailman. C. County sheriff's deputies. D. The POTUS. E. To read this story, check the description for the link. Check out /.org for more articles. /. News for nerds. Stuff that matters.